And do you have child support ordered against you yet?
I'm sure that's coming. We just had a hearing on the 20th, and
was this a temporary order, or is this going to be the final?
Yeah, you know, it's odd. I got the divorce decree, and it was temporary, full physical, full soul and legal custody to my ex-husband, and that's kind of awkward on a divorce decree. But we had a September 20th hearing, and just went through that, and we don't expect, of course, very much from that.
Yeah, so with no allegations of abuse, she even lost the presumption of legal custody.
Mm-hmm. I mean, that happened. That was very awkward.
This is rare. I mean, this doesn't happen. I mean, it happens to a lot of guys, but that I know of, and you probably know more women that it happens to than I do.
Well.
But, I mean, it does happen to both, and that tells me some of this is, you know, the individual judge, there's sexism that goes on there, but a lot of it is about the judge and their bias and their opinions and what they want to accomplish.
Tim, you would think that would have to be something very traumatic, very wrong with this woman to deprive her of all contact with three young children, ages 1, 5, and 7.
Mm-hmm.
That's unheard of. It's uncivilized. It's insensitive. It's unhuman is what it is. And it's happening in this country today.
Now,
this is only one case. Yeah. There are others.
Oh, yeah. There's
many.
Yeah. It's happening every day here.
It comes down to what you've been saying a long time. Judges can do anything they want. They're not accountable to anyone. And they abuse, not all judges, but there are many judges that abuse the power they were given.
And it's what Greg Wurzel has said over and over again, that you know, people say, well, you can appeal. Well, and he's testified at the legislature. We played tape here. He says, well, for all practicality, you can appeal. That just judge's decisions in a majority of cases ends up being the last decision, because to get a lawyer to appeal, you're dishing out $10,000. And the judge is purposely bankrupt, in my opinion. They personally bankrupt an individual so they will lose hope and don't appeal.
Tim, do you know how bad it is? More than half of all Minnesotans who appear in court do not have a lawyer. They cannot afford a lawyer. They try to be a lawyer themselves. They try to be pro se, and they just don't know what to do or how to do it. And in cases like Leah's, they are essentially without any remedy in this country.
Right. Oh, absolutely. And you'd think it shouldn't be.
That's
not really going on, but it is, and it's massive. Well, so who is taking care of the kids now?
You know, I'm not quite sure right now, because I understand the nanny, I believe, went to college. But there was a series, actually, of 20-something nannies. A couple were identical twins, and it's all from one family for some reason. I'm not quite sure why, but I don't know her. I've met her, one of them, anyway. Mm-hmm. I think there's 4 or 5 or something like that. But they're just 20-something nannies. And
are they parents? Are they mothers?
No. They're not mothers. In fact, the baby was taken. I just got done nursing her. She was taken at 11 weeks old and given to 20-something nannies that have never been mothers. And
now, is there any possibility that these nannies are sleeping with your ex-husband?
Yeah, my kids actually do state that they accidentally told my fiance and I that they've had to wake up the nanny in daddy's bed. So,
In other words, they're paid prostitutes, is what they are.
I believe so.
Paid prostitutes are caring for her kids.
Yeah, they're just and they're with them all the time. It's weekends, and you know, in fact, in trial it was. He was asked about, you know, because he said that they're employed from 7 to 4:30, no weekends, and that's it. Well, my fiancé and officer were at the house just a few days before trial because of the dog incident. They had to go. It was 11:30
at night. The dog incident. You want to just do a little bit about that?
Oh, the dog incident. My son's anger and his aggression has gotten severe.
Mm-hmm. And at 5 years old.
At 5 years old. He's a wonderful, adorable, sweet. Never like this before. In fact, we had a dog once, and he was worried about her because she was cold outside, and he had to go get kitchen towels and cover her up. You know, I mean, he's just a sweet boy. But his anger is off the charts. I mean, he saw me for the last, it's been probably a year, for 3 hours a week, mm-hmm. and then every other weekend. And, I mean, the abuse and the things that they have told myself and many others, it's It's enormous, and it's very hard on the kids. My son is a strong one. My daughter is, you know, a little bit more passive. But anyway, he his aggression has gotten so bad, he actually cut the tail of a 70-pound dog right through the spinal cord and artery and with the pruning shears.
And just attacked the dog and taken out his anger?
Yeah, you know, it's awkward. He drew a picture for the therapist and things, and it wasn't, you know, he was smiling in the picture. It wasn't. It's very awkward. But yeah, his aggression, I mean, he's pushed the baby down the stairs at his dad's house. He's killed baby bunnies in the backyard, stomping them with his boots. And animal abuse in young children is very bad.
It's a serious problem.
It
needs to be dealt with.
And
absolutely.
The courts have completely just,
yeah. So let's get back to this, the money issue. How do you think Judge Perkins himself could be tied into the money? Does he know your husband, your ex-husband?
I don't know. Sure seems to like him a lot.
Yeah. Well, Perkins in the courtroom, and I've been in front of him, and he's a very kind.
Mm-hmm.
He's got great court behavior from my experience.
Right.
But he never answered my questions that were before the court.
Yeah, and in his orders. So, yeah,
well,
he's very nice.
You know, and it's kind of a passive aggressive, and that's just the nature of judges. You're going to be passive aggressive because you can be nice,
destroys. You have to remember that Mr. Banken, Leah's ex-husband, has paid enormous sums to his lawyer, who's a very creative lawyer and absolutely merciless, totally insensitive to what he's doing. His name is Bannis.
Christopher Bannis.
And if you pay him substantial fees, like all lawyers, or at least like most lawyers, he will do whatever you ask him to do, as long as it's legal.
Mm-hmm.
It may not be in good conscience. It may not be ethical. It may be hurting these children.
Mm-hmm.
It may be devastating to this woman. But he does his job. He works for a person who's paying him money. And that is what the most important thing is to many lawyers. Those fees, it's a business.
Right.
And they operate it like a business and with no conscience and no ethics.
And there's nothing against the law or the rules to give money to judges.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. Nothing.
There is a rule that lets them give money to judges.
Absolutely. Right. Yeah, that's even more importantly. So, and there's a good chance that that might be changed this year.
I hope so. We both talked to legislators that say that's wrong, and we have to change it.
Yeah.
Legislators can't take money.
And Representative Smith was stopping that.
Yes.
And he's no longer there.
I mean, it's the children. It's not even, you know, the appalling nature of it and how deceitful and, there's little kids.
Now, this whole issue of best interest of the child, and that gets thrown out a lot. Yeah. There is really no such thing.
Well,
it is. You're right.
It is.
There is no best interest of the child. Mm-hmm. There's only one best interest, and that's of the judge
and how
it's going to affect him.
Right. Tim, I'd like you to judge for yourself. You've met Leah. You heard her a couple nights ago. The audience right now has met Leah. Does she strike you as a person who would be a bad parent or a mean parent or abusive?
No,
I don't think
so. Not at all.
No.
No. And most parents aren't.
That's correct.
Most parents aren't. And to be that way, you would definitely know and see characteristics. But, you know, you go in the courtroom, and that's why judges don't have witnesses that go in the courtroom, or why you couldn't get witnesses into your case, is because, well, they're just going to say things in your favor, you know? So what good is that type of witness?
My witnesses were never heard during trial.
Yeah, and even though they could rebut what's being said, judge won't allow it.
Mm-hmm.
And was there any backroom talking, you know, between
chambers.
The attorneys and the judge?
Oh,
and the
chamber
judge?
Meetings every time.
And
that's how they...
Did you hear anything that came out of that?
Yes, they had a meeting in chambers. Leah's lawyer was in there. And the judge told her, Judge Perkins, don't bother to introduce your witnesses. My mind is made up. It's pointless to bring in your witnesses. He wouldn't even listen to them.
I mean, child abuse. We're talking like severe, you know, these people have heard, you know, without even me around. I mean, and his mind's made up. It just doesn't make, it's, you know, obviously there's quite a few things involved behind the scenes.
So this money issue, we just got a little more, but just how many guardian ad litems have been on this case?
Three. One of them actually was signed in twice, meaning I think it was 2 6-month.
Okay. And some of them just removed themselves?
Oh, they actually, the ones recently, the Linda Gare actually was the one recently. She asked to be removed.
Okay. Tell me about one of your last court cases, the conversation you had with Judge Perkins.
You know, I ended up, of course, I don't have a lawyer at this point, and I rather enjoy it.
Okay.
Because, you know, I mean, there's been so many times I've been in the courtroom, and I've just, I mean, you want to go, ugh, wait a minute, you know? But, you know, I literally called Judge Perkins kind of out on the table. I don't necessarily remember, you know, how it happened, but I just told him flat out, I said, you know, there's, however you make your living or whatever you do, I'm like, knock yourself out. I said, but you're not doing it with my children at the expense of my kids.
Uh-huh.
And he said, are you suggesting that, you know, I'm taking, you know, money? And I said, yes. And he said, I have never in my 18 years, you know, taken money for a case. I said, well, that's wonderful. Then what's going on? And he just stared at me and he...
That's bold.
He didn't know what to say. And I think he was a little shell-shocked, which I, you know, I don't blame him, I guess. But I asked him, I said, you know, you can't answer that, can you?
Yeah.
And he just sat there and I said, you know, why don't I have my kids? What are you doing with these children? And towards the end, actually, we kind of got into a stare down.
Okay, we're running out of time, so you got to finish this in about 5 seconds.
Okay, yeah, we kind of got into a stare down and he kept asking me, do you have anything to say about your contempt? And I said, well, do you have anything to say about what you're doing with my children? And it just went back and forth and, yeah.
Okay.
So.
All right, people, we're running out of time. Remember, if you don't stand up for other people's liberties, who's going to stand up for yours? And good people don't do nothing. So find out what's going on. Go to the website here. God bless and good night.